The artificial intelligence model that we use, it creates sounds that nobody has ever heard before. The new instrument itself is a deformable, non-rigid instrument. And you can actually physically modify, change the form of the material. And that material is the musical instrument, so that the amount of pressure that you apply, the form that you create, that actually results in developing different sounds. Important part here is where we apply the artificial intelligence, that the sound synthesis is always brings you unusual sounds. In a way that you start playing an instrument with a particular sound, but when you take your hand away from the instrument, then it generates a totally new sound. This has been always our intention from the beginning, to look into the digital technologies and their particular role in artistic practices.
What I find interesting is kind of using it as a tool, as a support for your own creativity in using machine learning and deep learning to find connections between points that you hadn't thought of, and like merging things.
My music making process is always a kind of dialogue and interaction with the tools, and the machine learning I find provides an interesting twist on that, where we can make the tools maybe more autonomous. Some would say intelligent. I maybe hesitate to call it that at this point.
Well, we don't do guitar, but we look into artificial intelligence tools, for example, and they shape our relationship with our current musical instruments and the music that we intend to make. I'm Koray Tahiroğlu. I'm an academic research fellow in Aalto University School of Arts, and I'm also leading the research group Sound and Physical Interaction Design. We can even conclude that human without technology is impossible. So that the technology plays a crucial role in our relationship with the world, as well as in our relationship with the art.